MetalNationRadio.com.
This is Adam Onslaught for the Global Onslaught on Metal Nation Radio. Snake and Rachel from Skid Row are with me this afternoon. Hello.
Hello, Adam.
How you doing, man?
How's it going?
It's going fucking great.
It's gonna be better.
So you've just got here, you're just getting used to the garden out here at the fucking aeroplanes flying over and spoiling the sound on this recorder. So you're here today, you're going to be out there rocking it.
Yeah, these things are always, I mean, there's such a thrill for us to play and to be a part of Download, and it's such a legendary venue and it's a legendary festival. And Rachel was just speaking about this earlier. When we were growing up reading Kerrang! Magazine at the Import Record Store, we used to find, you know, the lineup for Donington, you know, the Monsters of Rock and stuff. And to see how that has morphed into Download, what's kept that same spirit alive as it's always had, it's an honor to be a part of it.
It's never gone away, ever.
No.
The transition from Download, from Monsters of Rock to Download has never really disappeared.
No, I applaud Andy Copping, man. He's done a great job. And the fact that we're able to come here after, you know, being a band for 25 years and be invited to play is an amazing honor for us.
Well, I think this festival needs bands like you here because it's important to keep the whole scene alive and to remember the guys that are, you know, been there all the time and been here all the way. And you guys, you've never stopped touring. Where are you? Obviously, you're in Donington today, but where are you going after this?
We leave for Spain. We have three shows in Spain. Then we have Switzerland. We're doing Hellfest in France. A couple French shows, Switzerland and Slovenia. We've never been there before. So we've been hitting it pretty hard, you know, and we have the new mini album coming out in August. So we're just kind of prepping for that. And, you know, we're a band that we don't like days off. Let us play as much as possible. We play festivals and then we'll play wherever, you know. We like to go into small towns every now and then, play a really cool little joint, make it special, and we love it, man. We love it. We get bagged on for it, for playing small places sometimes, but we're like, screw you, man. It's all about the rock and roll fans, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah. And that's the best way to keep in touch with them, I guess, with your fans.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you get new fans and old fans here for you guys, and when you play the smaller venues, it's nice, a bit of a doff of the cap for those guys, I guess.
Well, again, I think that we come from the school of thought that this is a gift, man. This isn't like a birthright or anything like that. This is a gift, the fact that we get to play music in front of people for a living. We talk about this all the time. It's something that never gets lost on us. It's really an amazing thing, and it's incredibly humbling that we get to do this. It really is. I think far too many people take it for granted, and we certainly do not.
I think every band, no matter how big they are or how big they were or how big they're going to get, should play in small towns, in small places.
Absolutely.
Because it's fun, first of all, and it just means a lot, you know? It means a lot to the people that come that live in the outskirts of a major city, like so far that they can't even afford to get to that city. You go out to them, they bought your record. You should go out to them.
Yeah.
You should be kissing their ass to
exactly.
Play in front of them, you know?
Exactly.
So that's been our mindset from the beginning.
That's fantastic, and I really appreciate the time this afternoon with us here at Metal Nation Radio. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Adam.
Guys.
Very cool to speak with you.
You guys rock. Take care.
Thank you, man.
United we rock. Metal Nation Radio.